Good morning, children. Yes, children. Happy New Year. Yes. Now, already we have learned one lesson about the village, that is village panchayat. Now, you see, children, here you see the picture. You see the picture. This is village and this is city and this is city. And if you see the picture, you know any difference ma? in the village and the city? Yes, there will be many differences between the village and the city. Okay ma, what difference will be there? In the population it will be there, difference will be there. Yes, not only population, the buildings, the roads, everything it will be different. The public amenities they want, that also will be more they want. Okay na, that is, so how the government will work? Which government will work? Yes, in village we have said, village panchayat is working. How it is working everything? Sorry, we have learned in the last lesson. Yes sir, now today we are going to learn about the cities, about the towns and cities, how the government is going to work. That is our lesson, that is local self-government in urban areas. What is the lesson we are learning? Local self-government in urban areas. Urban means what? Cities and towns. Yes. This lesson we are learning. Yes, you have seen that. In the village and cities, there is more difference is there. Yes, if you see, towns and cities are places where large number of people live. Towns and cities are the places where large number of people live. Towns and cities where large number of people are going to live. Large number of people are going to live. Not only that, roads are very wider and busier. Roads, if you see, very very wide, very big roads we are having. Yes or no ma? We are having very big roads. And always you see, traffic jams only will be there. Yes or no? Yes. And not only that, there are more shops, supermarkets we are having, malls we are having, theatres we are having, so many we are having in the cities. Yes. Vehicles are there, industries are there, and they require more planning also. These cities require more planning. What we require? More planning we require. Yes or no ma? We require more planning we require. Yes. And more public amenities also we require. More public amenities also we require. Why? Because more population we said. More public amenities also we require. Yes. Not only that, always people are shifting from villages to towns. People are shifting from villages to towns. Because of that, what happened? The cities are growing day by day. And new colonies are coming. Yes, sir. People are shifting from the villages. So, what is happening? New colonies are coming up. Shifting. Yes, sir. So, what is happening? New colonies are coming up. Yes, sir. And these new colonies, if you see, yes, sir, are in the form of slum areas. They are in the form of slum areas. Slum area means where they don't have proper drainage system, where they don't have water, yes, sir, drinking water, where they don't have electricity. That area is called as slum area. And they should be, so these slum areas, what the government should do? Yes, they live in a, the poor people live and work there. So they should be assured of water and electricity supply, electricity supply, transport, schools and hospitals. And major problem in the towns and cities, we are going to get what? Disposal of garbage. What we are going to get? We are going to get the problem of disposal of garbage. Where the garbage? It's a city, already we said, very big. So many people are there. So garbage collection is very, very major problem, very great problem. Yes, sir, here. It's a major problem. They will ask you also. You choose the correct answer. Major problem in cities is what? Is the disposal of
waste materials or garbage and drainage system. Okay, children. Yes, providing public amenities in towns and cities is very complex one. Providing public amenities in the cities, it is a very complex, very difficult job. Very difficult job. To do that, we need an organization. What we need? We need an organization. We need an organization. That organization is called as municipality. We need a big organization. That organization is called as what? Municipality. What it is called as? Municipality. Yes, ma'am. What is called as municipality? For you, one question, ma'am. What is that? Yes, recently we have completed our mayor municipal elections. In that, who was our mayor? Who elected as our mayor? Find it out. From which party it is? Okay, now find it out that. Okay, and in the Zoom class, you can tell me the answer. Yes. So municipality, and this municipality is of three bodies. Ma'am, municipality is of three bodies, three parts. What are those? Municipality. Yes, sir. Three kinds of municipal bodies are there. Municipality. It is of three. One is Nagar Panchayat. One is what? Nagar Panchayat. Nagar Panchayat. Where the population is below 20,000. Next we are having, not below 20,000, that is 20 to 40,000. Where the population is 20 to 40,000. Next we are having Municipal Council. Municipal Council. And where the population is 40,000 to 3 lakhs. 2-3 lakhs. 40,000 to 3 lakhs. Yes. Next we are having Municipal Corporation. Municipal Corporation. Yes, where the people are above 3 lakhs. Okay, ma? Like this, our municipality is divided into three main parts. Nagar Panchayat, where the population is 20 to 40,000. Municipal Council, 40 to 3 lakhs. And Municipal Corporation, 3 lakhs. Above 3 lakhs. Now, how these municipalities are formed? They are formed like village panchayat through the elections only. And here also these municipalities are divided into wards. And again they are divided into divisions also. Yes. And the people elect whom? The people are going to elect their representatives. There we have seen sarpanch and ward members. Here also we are going to elect the representatives. What they are called? Yes, so the elected person is representative. What they are called? Yes. The representatives are called councillors in municipal towns. Yes, so here they are called as councillors. Councillors. And here they are called as towns and corporators. Here they are called as corporators. In corporation cities, people are elected as representatives. These representatives are called councillor in municipal council and corporators in towns and corporators in corporation cities. Yes, apart from this, not only we had councillor and corporators, we also had mayor or chairperson. And sarpanch in the panchayats. Yes, and not only these two, we are going to have, yes, mayor or chairperson. You are understanding, no, ma'am? Chairpersons. Okay, now we are going to have. Yes, we have to find out who is our mayor. Yes. Now, how does the municipality work? Next, we are going to see how does the municipality work. Yes, already we have seen in the sarpanch. Yes, here ward will be there, ward members will be there. All together, yes, have the Gram Sabha meetings and that. But here in the city, if you see, so many people are there. So many people are there. So many amenities they need. Then how they are going to work? Yes, they are going to form into the departments. Different departments are formed. According to that, this municipality is going to work. Understanding, ma'am? Yes. How it works? As a, it has many tasks. Municipality has many tasks to perform. Many tasks to do. Main thing what we said, disposal of garbage. What the tasks to perform? Like water supply, street lighting, maintaining and building roads, drainage and garbage disposal, running schools, ration shops, hospitals, among other. Beside of new development works also they have to do. Now all this cannot be done by few people or by the corporators or councillors alone. So the municipalities employ large number of workers. They will have so many workers. Not only workers they will have the officers. They will have the officers to do all this work. Not only them, they will have the clerks. They are going to have the clerks and accountants also. So all these things, all these members together, they will work for the development of the cities. Yes sir, municipality has made a, not only that, municipality has made a number of departments. Yes sir, headed by an officer who is responsible for the proper working of that department. Not only that, yes sir, a number of departments are there. Yes sir. And yes sir, this department officer will be responsible for that. For that department. What are the departments? Examples are like water supply department. Yes sir, next electricity department, educational department, garbage disposal department, like that. So many departments we have. Water supply department. So many departments we have, ma. Yes. And electricity department, the garbage disposal department. And now if you see how the work of the, what is the work of the councillor? What is the work of the councillor? The councillor stay in touch with the people of the ward to understand their needs and problems and discuss them in the municipality meeting. Same thing like the sarpanch. Councillor also works like that. Councillor stay in touch with the people of the ward, to understand their needs and problems and discuss them in the municipality meetings. Yes, sir, we will have the municipality meeting. In that, he is going to discuss. And to ensure that all the different kinds of the work are properly thought about, the municipality as a number of communities and the councillors are assigned to these committees. The work of these committees is to review the functioning of the municipality department and plan new works to be undertaken. Not only that, ma, they prepare proposals which are discussed in the municipality meetings and passed. These decisions are implemented by the officers and employees of the municipality. Yes, the ward councillors ensure that the needs of their wards are placed before the council when decisions are taken. They also stay in touch with the people of the ward who make the take their problem to them. Yes sir, all this, we are going to, all these problems, how they are going to do, we are going to see with a community representation, all these things we are going to see in the next class. Okay, we are going to see in the next class. Okay, children. Yes, just go through the lesson, how a community representation will take place, I will tell you. Now, go through the lesson very well. Read all that. Any doubts are there, you can ask me in the Zoom class. Very easy lesson. Okay, if you understood village panchayat, local self-government in urban areas also, you can understand very easily. What is it? Mainly municipality. Okay, children? Yes. Thank you. Have a good day.